Welcome to Game With Us. Today, Apocryphile is going to continue to play the Banner Saga as best he can, because it's very difficult. But he's going to get his best shot. So, everyone, welcome. Of course, my game is working again. Welcome to Game With Us. Let's try this. Why are you not cooperating with me? Welcome, everyone. I'm your host, Apocryphile. You're watching Game With Us. I'm trying to get Banner Saga to work with my exploit here, but it's being a douche. Bam. What the fuck is going on? Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the show. Again, I'm your host, Apocryphile, having some technical difficulties every day with this game. It's awesome. Thanks everybody for tuning in, showing up. I'm a little tired. I went and watched Day After Tomorrow. Edge of Tomorrow. Yeah, I'm so tired, I can't remember the name of the movie. I went and watched Edge of Tomorrow today, and the movie got out at like 1. So, and then I had to eat, and then I had to sleep. So I didn't get very much sleep, but here I am anyways, because I don't want to disappoint you guys, and, well, I want to play this damn game, and I want to beat it. But that remains to be seen. Anyway, well, let's see if this is going to work. It did work. Am I in the wrong spot? How did I get over here? This game confuses me sometimes, or exploit confuses me. It doesn't seem to save any of my settings anymore. It's just awesome. Anyway, we're gonna try to play this damn game. So yeah, let's do this. Resume. So when last we left off yesterday, I had to reset my save because Gunulf died in a random choose your own adventure plot. So we're not gonna do that today. Oh, we're just gonna go. We're just gonna go with it. I was gonna rest after this. Before that guy dies, I'm definitely resting so I can level my guys up. Now this is the this is that battle with those slingers. So hopefully I can get through it. And when they, man, I really should take her, though. I'll take her instead of him. But I should, whatever. It doesn't matter. Anyways, I really hope that one guy spawns, because one guy did spawn once instead of two. So if I can get just one guy to spawn, that'll just be so much better than trying to wrestle with two of those slingers. But I did bring an archer this time, because fuck those guys. Alright, so we're gonna move you here. Move you here. We got ready. Let's do this. Look, I can move him up and kill one guy at the very beginning. Let's do that. So that is a really good thing about having to be able to spend extra willpower. It's just the extra movement is pretty nice. So we're going to kill this guy. Bam! He is dead. We like that. Alright, this guy. I'm just going to rush forward with all my guys and trap these guys in a little formation. Deflect. Nice. Now see what's gonna happen is I'm gonna move all my guys over here, and the little guy's gonna spawn back here in the back. Oh my god, my allergies. Ugh, okay. So, this guy's close enough. So, I'm going to move. I'm not going to waste all my willpower on this guy because he doesn't have a lot. So, we just got to get up there for. Okay, so she can't attack anybody. Oh man, putting her here was a bad idea. This guy should go first. That way I can go straight instead of having to walk around this guy. Slag and burn is not going to work. Alright, well, that's it. That's it for her. Now, he can hit this guy for 7. That guy has 6 hit points. We're doing that. Absolutely. Okay, now there's 2 of them. Now they're in god mode. So I have to be able to kill one of them very quickly. Okay, this guy can take 2. And this guy can take 1. Great. I love that part. Well, he's not going to make it, okay. But that's okay. He's already killed one guy. I'm not going to care anymore about my guys getting knocked down in combat. I just don't care. Alright, since we can only do 2 damage to this guy, I think Sundering Impact will probably be my best bet here, because I'll remove some of his armor. And it did more damage. Turd Ferguson, what is up, man? Alright, you just lurk. We will be here. And yes, that's probably the best thing to say is you lurk, we'll be here. I'll talk to you occasionally even though you're not gonna type, but I know you're here. Thank you, Turd Ferguson, for showing up to game with us while I struggle through Banner Saga. Alright, let's see. I'm gonna trap this guy in. I don't want him getting away. We're just gonna block him in here, even though technically he's not blocked in, there's no kind of opportunity attacks. Oh, good. He gets to go. My guy gets to go. Yay. And we are going to take this guy out for sure. And then this guy gets his one last attack, which he didn't kill my guy with. I'm going to sit her right... you know what? Not move there. I'm going to move her kind of like right in the middle of the battlefield so that whoever... Well, hopefully... You guys don't spawn and just immediately put her down because, well, that's probably what's going to happen. Okay, this guy can do 6 damage. This guy has 7 HP, so we're going to walk up, spend willpower, and get this fight over with. Kill a few more as they flee. Because it says I have a chance to get items, so we'll see about that. And 3 spawn. Okay, and then she could probably come over here and do slag and burn on this guy. I guess. Man, I'm taking a risk here, but I think she could do it from this square here. She might be able to do it from this. Let's move here. And if she can't do it, well, that just sucks. Alright, so she's going to put it here. Yeah. Ha ha ha. You can tango with me all day, buddy. Alright, so this guy is gonna go this way. Oh, deflect. This guy is also gonna go this way. He's gonna go right. I can put him here. Or willpower. Yeah, let's do it. Alright, let's see. Oh god. When am I gonna get my turn? Alright, so he can take out. Can he take out any of these guys? Fuck no, he's too weak. let's do something to someone. Let's do Sundering Impact to this guy. And then we're going to have my guy here. We're going to have him, Gunolf, go up and just hammer both these guys into the ground. And then that will leave this guy. Well, when he gets to go. Well, you know what? I'm going to knock him out too. Fuck it. Oh, I didn't. Oh, that's right, because I only hit two guys, three guys. Alright, she should not do Slag and Murr at this point, because everybody's going to gangbang this guy in a second. Wait, what did I just do? Alright, she wants to do this. Bam, take that. Oh, perfect. Actually, not perfect. He went to the exact wrong spot. Okay, this guy can't do anything. So he's just gonna sit here because he can't move or do anything. And this guy can go right here and put this guy on the ground. Let's do that. And I didn't actually lose anybody, amazingly enough. I don't know how that is possible, but that's how it happened. And that's what we're gonna go with. And we're not gonna let Gunolf fucking suicide this time, because he totally suicided. It's like, I'm just gonna hang onto this fucking cart until I die. Stupid asshole. Come on. Who does that? Alright, so as soon as we get out here, we are camping. What in the depths are these? Yeah, I read this yesterday. Ah, damn it. I don't even get a chance. I'm going to try to knock the dredge off first. See if that works. Alright. Shit. Wow. Okay, I got... Wow. That totally... my god. I hate this game. I really do. I hate it. So yesterday I got two chances. This time I fucked it up on the first one. That's amazing. Fuck. I'm so dumb. I should just, oh my god, really, dude? Really? This game. What a pile of shit. Fuck you, game. Fuck you and your stupid fucking camp. Just get a fucking goddamn it, really? Alright, we're gonna do this. We're gonna go to my heroes. Well, at least I get to do this. Who needs an upgrade? Let's find out. Promote. Oh, right, I only have a finite amount of XP to spend, so... Oh my god, dude, he has... How much XP is that going to cost to promote him? I don't think I have enough XP to promote all these people. That's awesome. Your XP to promote your guys is a finite resource. I was reading that, too. I was reading reviews about this game, they were like... So... You can't... even promote all your people because you're gonna run out of stuff and then you won't be able to buy anything. It's like, what's the fucking point of leveling up your dudes if you can't level them up because your XP to raise your guys is also your money? So yay, the XP I have to level my guys up is also the money I use to buy supplies. That's really good. It's really good. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and level up Khan. Yeah, improve your ability for 10 renown. Alright, so he has 2 points to spend. This is maxed. We're going to max this out because it's awesome. Spending 3 willpower to turn would be baller. And then we're going to do... I should probably raise this willpower some. Because he can spend 3 a turn. Should I do that? No. Let's not do that yet. I don't have enough willpower. I'm gonna continue to max out his strength for now because that's what he does. I'm pretty sure that's what he does. Anyways. Fuzzy Wolf, what is up? Welcome to Game With Us. Good to see you. I'm just sitting here struggling through the Banner Saga. It's very difficult. Promote. Build higher stats. 15 renown. Holy shit. Alright, I'm going to max his strength out. And then we're going to give him... He doesn't usually armor break, so... I'm going to give him another point of willpower, I think. No. He needs armor. He needs armor. Yes, thank you for showing up. It is good to see you again. Eirik, we'll promote him. Alright, he has 2 points. He is not really a frontline fighter. We're going to give him a point of willpower because that's what he uses to rally people. And then we're going to give him another point of strength. He'll have 9 and 9. Because his strength is also his hit points, so he needs it. Hit points and strength. Like, strength is so good because it's your damage and your hit points, so. Alright, and who else? Bursi? This guy? I should leave him at rank 1. I already have a Warhawk. And this guy's one of the bad guys. At least in my mind, he's a bad guy. He may not be a bad guy at all. Siege Archer. She definitely needs a promotion. She does her break occasionally. But Archer's... Oh, wow. Her strength is max now. Holy shit. Alright, well... Yes, I should put point in armor break, because when she's not doing a ton of damage, I want her to be able to break people's armor. Is that what I want? If I give her another point in willpower, she could continue to do those siege arrow things. Man. Let's max out... Let's max this out, because she has 6 willpower, so she could do 2 rounds at 3 apiece. Sounds good. And... God, do I level this guy up? I might as well. And he's a Warhawk, so I'm going to give him this, and I'm going to give him this. Yeah. That's good. And I don't think this guy needs a promotion, does he? At least I hope not. I hate this guy. Nope. What about Gris? No, he hasn't even been in a fight yet. Let's go ahead and search. Let's put her here. And let's not put her behind these dudes. Let's put her... Actually, yeah, let's put her behind those dudes, because... I don't care. She's not going to be able to... I don't want to rush her in and get her owned, because she's not bringing me hit points, so... Alright, training heroes, rest, leave. Let's leave. I did what I wanted to. Now we have to do that fight again, and then I have to save Gunnel from dying stupidly. But at least everybody's higher level now. This should be a little bit different. We'll see. Ready? I already picked my party. So now, my Warhawk is a little better. My, I can't remember what Gunnelf is. What? Wow, look, the battle has totally changed. Well, that's cool at least. But it's totally different. Totally. Interesting. Alright, so this is a shield guy. We're gonna have Akan go after him. We're gonna move this guy back here. Move Akan here. We'll move. I have 3 dudes with shields. Maybe I should save a con. Maybe I should have a con to go after. You know what? That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do this. We're gonna have Moger fight this boss guy. We're gonna put these three shield dudes here. We're gonna have a Warhawk here. And we're gonna put Hakan here. And we're gonna put the archer in the middle. Totally different. I guess when you level up your guys, you get different battles. What do you know? Alright, so we're gonna move Hakan here. We're gonna take this guy out. No, not end your turn. Attack. Take this guy out. Alright, so here comes this guy. Waste of attack, man. A waste of attack. Alright, we're gonna have... I gotta remember his... What is Moger's ability? Bring the pain. What does that do? Break damage to target and plus one to return the favor for the round. Okay, so return the favor really doesn't work on these ranged guys. So I think I'm just gonna do armor break on this guy because... Like, I mean, really, it's not going to work on any of these guys, so it's just wasted. Wasted stats. Shamu, what is up? Welcome to game with us. How's Canada? Hope everything's going great for you today, Shamu. Hope everything's going great. All right, so we're going to move. I guess we'll move here to block this guy in. I'm going to move all the way down here because he's not going to be able to move in the little gap. How's the game going tonight? It's going as per usual. I managed to level my guys up, but it's going per usual. I'm gonna say this is gonna be better tonight. I'm not gonna let the game kick my ass so much. So, but it's not going bad. So we're gonna break this guy's armor here. Urban Garden, nice dude. Alright, and now that this guy... Can we drop him? 7? I think we can? I can't remember how much... Oh no, he can only spend 1 willpower, so we can't do that. So we're gonna move him back here and take this guy out because... Fuck these guys. Alright. Ooh, he spent 2 willpower to hit her in the face. What a bitch. Alright, 6 and 7. Who are we going to take out here? Let's take out that higher armor guy. So we're going to attack. Now what does the battering ram do? Knock adjacent unit up to 4 tiles for 1 armor damage. Plus 1 unit per they pass through? Hell no. I want these guys to stay right next to me. Alright, so we're going to attack the higher health... Wait. Yeah, so we're going to attack the higher health guy. That's been a willpower. Because... Yeah. I'm going to take out the hardest target possible. Now see, that works for me. Alright, now this guy... Can take 1 damage from him. And what is his ability? Malice. Taunt the unit and cause him to attack you on your next turn. No, I'm not gonna do that. He's already attacking me, so. And he can't move anywhere. He's trapped. So we're gonna just break the shit out of his armor. Man, that's some bullshit. Alright, I wonder if we could slag and burn these guys. Or if I should just shoot one of them with an arrow. Yeah, let's just armor break this guy. For 4 points? Does that sound like a good idea? Or we can armor break this dude here. No, I'm gonna leave him there because I don't want him scooting around the battlefield, so we're gonna drop a 4 point armor break onto this guy. Oh, nice, and it broke his... Oh, that's right, straight line. Fuck yeah. All right, we're gonna move him here. died. She's just gonna beat the fuck up. Right, so this guy can take 8 damage, and this guy can take 7. I'm taking this guy out right now. Yay, he gets one more attack. And now he is toast. Kill a few more as they flee. How many more show up? 2, of course. Of course, 2. We're just gonna leave him here. Rest. Oh, 3. Okay. Better go attack a con. That's fine. Nope, they're gonna put her down. Fine, I don't care. As long as they don't kill every single one of my guys, I don't give a fuck. Alright, so he could take out one of... Oh, shit. He could take out this guy. Let's take out this guy before they kill me. Wow, 4 damage. Brutal. Oh yeah, there's 2 of them. I forgot, now they're in super mode. Continue to break this guy's armor before I die. Alright, can this guy... He could do 11. Let's do 11 to this guy. Yeah, Hakan! Sweet. Granted item. Hey, we did. Now this time, so I went back. I fought this fight 3 or 4 times. This time I fought a different battle, and this time at the end I got an item, a blue item. Yeah, I know he's not though. But that was awesome. That was awesome. All right. Stumbles out of the brush. So what kind of stuff do you have, Shamu? Tell us about your garden. What all is in there? What? Oh, did I? Oh, I see. 3 types of basil, 2 types of parsley, some lemongrass. Oh, I love lemongrass, man. Garlic chives, oregano, tomatoes, pickling cucumbers, regular cucumbers, strawberries. Holy shit, man, that's badass. My duty, he grunts, he doesn't budge. You wonder how much is responsible. He finds his reason for living. The treasure surrounds a footing and is trying to clamber up over the cart. The tree creaks under the weight. Order him to let go with authority. The roar, it sounds more like you just stabbed him in the side and gave an order. Gunnel lets go of the cart. It flips over the side in a flash, followed much later by a dull thud and crack. At the base of the steep cliff, Hundreds of yards below, the treasure cart has exploded into a frozen firework of gold, valuables, and yaks and dredge gore. That was a costly mistake, grits Uben between his clenched teeth. You wonder why that dredge went after the yaks in the first place. Then you realize a bigger problem is a vast fortune now lying at the bottom of a cliff. Good call, Uben. What choice do we have? Even if we could gather it up, we've nothing to haul it. He sounds defeated, but resolute moving on. You begrudgingly set off, leaving a king's ransom beneath your feet. Yay. Great. A king's ransom? It doesn't do anything to me. I don't lose any supplies, or I don't lose any renown. That's cool. Speaking of renown, we better rest after this. That's right, Shenlu. The caravan stops, Godstone looming overhead, for a short rest. The warriors are glad for it, and the stone gives you an ancient sense of being watched over in a comforting way. It didn't help the bodies underneath it, though. The earth at the base of the Godstone is scarred, like a struggle occurred. Merchants, no dredge. Encircling Dingler are a variety of goods, a barrel of mead, who knows how old, loose silver, a statue made of soapstone, offerings to a dead god. Leave the offerings, but check for the merchant's brother. In the midst of the pile of bodies, a glitter catches your eye. You fish a gold necklace out from a jerkin to find 5 golden rings strung on it. The merchant's brother. Guess he didn't make it, you mutter. Take the necklace with intent to return it. You toss the necklace to Moger and tell him to hang on to it. If anyone can be trusted, it's him. Plus 10 renown. Don't know what made them think the Godstone be safe, Moger grunts. We're completely exposed up here. And he says, if we're gonna rest, I think we have to do it a little further away. Examine the Godstone. Dingler was always one of the favorites amongst men. God of good fortune. They believed he brought luck, wealth, or whatever else you wish you had, but couldn't get on your own. The word fortune has a lot of meanings. Eventually you move on. Let's camp real quick, because I want to level my guys up before, and I want to check out this new magic item too. Alright, so let's see, let's go to heroes, where are they at? Ooh, here they are, check them out, items. Horse score. Shoes made from the hooves of horseborn have long been rumored to make one faster, if not cold-hearted. Plus 1 movement, plus 10% dodge strength attacks. That's awesome. Yeah, it's pretty awesome, Shamu. Alright, so plus 1 to movement, and plus 10 to dodge strength attacks. Who should we put that on? Put it on Gunwolf, because he's a badass. Put it on Hakan, because he's my man. Let's put it on, oh, let's promote Hakan. Fuck yeah, 9 of 9. Boom. Alright, now let's do... Let's max out his strength. Let's put another point in willpower. Another point in strength. There we go. Anybody else? Moger, promote. Yeah. Man, he could actually use another point of health. Well, no, let's leave. Let's do this. 4, 4, 15. Let's do that. That looks good. Anybody else? Alright, that's it. Alright, and we're going to put these horse horse score on Hakan. Bam. Just like that. Cool. Sweet ass sweet. And then we are going to continue on. I think. Great morale. Yeah. Time to leave. Moving on. In the distance, you see smoke rising from the trees. Dredge aren't known for setting fire, says Moger, but it does get their attention. We use fires like that to lead them along in the Great Wars. Yeah, but they'd wised up to that after a while, interjects another warrior. Or it could be someone trying to get our attention, claims Fasolt. The other group from Schlid were sent this way. No matter how you look at it, investigating will cost time. Check it out yourself. Hell yes, check it out yourself. The sounds of fighting ahead compel you to crash through the foliage, sidestepping Varl and Dredge bodies along the way. You burst onto a scene of carnage. A vast number of Varl surrounded by Dredge. Explanations can wait. You charge into the fight! Yeah! Man, I just take all Varl all the time. Yeah. Wow. That is funny, man. Yep. Alright, so, you know what? I don't really like her. I'm gonna leave Luden and his fucking cronies down here, and I'm gonna take these guys, because he could give people willpower back, and I like that, so we're gonna do this. This looks good to me. So let's see what's going on in this little clearing. Okay. So I have just a few places I can stand. So let's move him here. Let's move Moger here. Let's move this guy here. We'll move him here, because he doesn't need to be in the fighting at all. And that looks good. Yeah, they are. It's coming along. So now if I move him up here and take this guy out, it's gonna set them into super mode, and they're gonna start getting 10 attacks per turn. And it's just going to be these guys. So I am not going to do that. I'm not killing this guy first. Because if I set these guys into super duper mode. Because basically what's going to happen is, if I kill this guy right now, these two guys are going to get 10. They're going to get, basically, instead of, like, the, I mean, this guy here, the 16-9 guy and the 7-13 guy, they're going to be getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 attacks per turn. Stupid. That is probably... That's the dumbest thing about this game. How enemies just... Like, when there's two left, they turn into gods, and they get an attack for every character on the screen. Well, I guess it would be 3 attacks per turn each. But still. As he gets 1 attack per turn, they get 3 attacks. Alright, so we're gonna we're just gonna move into the fight. I don't even care. We're not gonna take this guy out first. We're gonna leave him. So we're gonna pick the hardest target. And not him, because he has a low strength. So we're just going to wear down this guy's armor. That's what we're going to do. We're just going to wear down his armor. Now, that's what I should have done with the con. I should have done that, but I wasn't thinking, so... I absolutely should have a... No, don't do that. I absolutely should have busted that guy's armor, but I just fucking forgot about it. Damn, dude. That's crazy. That cold. The cold is crazy. We're gonna intern. Alright, this guy's gonna go, and of course, everybody's gonna focus fire this guy. Which is fine, I don't give two shits. And then we're gonna... Man, should we do 5 health damage to this guy? Yes, we should. Let's do as much as we can. Let's do 7. Oh, excellent. That worked for me. And then I'll just take this guy in here, like, right here. Bam. And I'll bust this guy's armor up. Willpower. Anybody? I don't think so. Not yet. Alright, so we're gonna have him move up. I'm just gonna move him up. Just for shits and grins. I think someone has spent willpower. Let's see, this guy's 4 of 4. 7 of 5. 7 of 5. 5 of 4. 6 of 4. So everybody's kind of over willpowered right now. So... no one needs willpower. He's gonna end his turn. What in the fuck is this guy doing? I've seen them do this before. I don't like that. God damn it. Alright, so I am gonna break this guy's armor. I'm just gonna take the rest of his armor away. I do not know what he's doing, but I do not like that one bit. He's probably summoning more reinforcements or something. If I can only get to him. I'm not gonna be able to. These guys are so huge. We're just gonna sit him right here. Yep, he's having another dude. Well, at least when I start wrecking face, I can leave the small guys. Alright, this guy I could do 6 damage to. Let's do that. Let's do 6 damage to this guy. Let's do 7 damage to this guy. Nah, I don't need to. 6 is gonna be fine. Oh wow, look, he can actually take a guy out. Let's do that. Guy's armor. God damn it. Ugh. It's so frustrating. Alright, let's go ahead and take this guy out. Because, fuck this guy. 18 damage, let's do it. Promote! Holy shit, he got another promotion? God. We can take this guy out too. Let's do that. Hell yes. Promote. Yeah, one guy left. Oh, I could do 10 damage to him. Let's do that. Let's take him down. Sweet ass sweet. Victory! Your renown grows. Rewards. Gunoff ready for promotion. Gris is ready for promotion. And probably not enough renown to level them. Alright, well anyways, let's continue on. And I'm gonna camp as soon as possible. Bam. Ah, fuck, man. Can't even click the button fast enough. As the fighting wraps up, one of the Varl puts his axe away and puffs on a pipe. Akan, he greets you. Glad you saw our signal. He explains they had come from Schlid and were surrounded. He spotted you in the distance and lit a fire to draw your attention, at the risk of drawing the dredge as well. Back at the caravan, their sizable detachment joins your ranks. That's a lot of Varl. And we're gonna camp. And then we're going to go to Heroes. And then we're going to go find people who need promotions. I can't believe he got another promotion already. Fuck it, man. Let's promote him. 20 XP. Fuck yeah, dude. Do it. Don't even care. I think he's maxed out. He is. He's a rank 5 Warhawk. That's pretty badass. He's got 2 points available. Let's max out his... let's do willpower expenditure, and let's do more willpower. Alright, promote my strong arm to rank 2. And what does he do again? Pushes him, so he breaks armor. So let's max out his armor break, and then give him another point of armor. Or I could just max his armor break totally. Man, what to do? Yeah, let's just go ahead and max out armor break. Anybody else? Alright, we're done. Alright. And then let's continue on. See what we have in store for us. Ogre comes to you privately. I've seen some of the warriors disappearing, he says. At first, I thought it was my imagination. Now I'm certain several have just gone missing. Mostly men, but some Varl too. Can't quite figure it. If it's abandonment, you can't let it stand. I'm gonna demand answers personally. Watch and follow? Huh. The traitor's down! Demand answers personally. You call the name Varl to your tent and demand an explanation. They tell you they saw Luden's men going back to the wrecked wagon to gather gold and followed. They admit to taking some for themselves. Is a sack of crap. I'm gonna punish them and speak with Luden. I ordered it, says Luden when you confront him. I sent my men to bring back gold from the cart you left behind. If you have a problem with your warriors joining, maybe you should keep them under control. Pummel him in his stupid face. I want to do that so bad, but I'm not going to. he's very lucky that I want to do the proper thing. Insists he explain his actions. You left a pile of gold at the bottom of a hill. What are the chances it'll still be there months from now? The only reason we aren't each carrying a share is because you don't trust us. Threaten him if he doesn't stop. He could keep the fucking loot. I've already stopped. Too far now for anyone to catch back up to the caravan. His smug demeanor is nearly unbearable. I can't wait for this guy to die. I really hope he does. Your warriors demand a break. You halt the caravan with a sigh. In all honesty, you're starting to feel the altitude and weariness yourself. Mugger leans on a fallen tree, fiddling with a crust of bread. Getting colder, he says, staring into the distance. You can see Ridgehorn just start to peek around the mountains. A flock of ravens float across a clear sky toward the fort. We should follow those birds. Are you okay? Without another word, Mugger starts running toward the birds and tumbles over the cliff. Suddenly, he's gliding through the air, flapping his arms for all they're worth. He swoops toward Ridgehorn before bursting into flames and plummeting into the tower, which crumbles like a log from a smoldering campfire. What in the fuck? Please tell me I'm dreaming. You think you've lost your mind. Then you wake up. Okay, good. I'm like, what the fuck is going on here? You don't remember setting up camp or falling asleep in front of crackling logs. What is going on, you mutter. Mugger approaches you at the campfire. Hakan, did you see? Yeah, you both agree to keep it to yourselves. Wow. Let's check here. Anything? No. Alright. And let's just keep going. Unless we need to rest. Map. Days of supplies, renown, good morale. I wonder if I should rest until it's great. Oops, I shouldn't have done that. Just stop. I didn't know it was going to just turn off automatically. Okay, let's go. Wasted a day. Oh well, whatever. Hopefully we don't starve for a day. And if we do, who cares? I'm sure you've seen them, Mugger says, but we're being followed. Dredge have been on our asses since we left the Godstone. Lots of them. I'm sure there's plenty in front of us too. But we're just half a day out from thick woods. We might lose them there. Man, what to do? What to do? I should probably just lose them. Good. More slags to kill. You immediately wheel around and face the enemy. Charge. Rush into battle. Fuck it, man. Let's do this. There's badasses with me. What are they gonna do? Kill me? Absolutely. I ain't scared. Yeah, there's some big guys here. That's okay. That's okay. I got badasses too. This just looks good. Let's go with it. Alright, so who's up first? That'll be Hakan. I think I'm gonna go over here and take this guy out. Because he's in the back. And screw that guy. How much willpower is that gonna take me? 2? Yep. Look, I have 2 extra willpower. Let's do it. And we're gonna just mow this guy down. Mako Marquis, what is up, man? Good to see you again. What is up? I'm just playing some Banner Saga. Box sitting here next to me, reading some stuff. It's good to see you, man. It is definitely good to see you. Alright, so, Moger, I can't ever remember his ability. Bring the pain to. Let's do that. So let's move over here. Let's actually move right here. And we're going to bring the pain on this guy. Ooh, I can actually put a willpower behind this. Let's do that. Because, to hell with that guy. Bam! And that guy's dead next round. I am taking my Warhawk and putting him down in the ground. Oh, man, dude, that sucks big time, man. That sucks big time. Now, if I move him here, I might actually be able to get this. You know, I'm not going to need to worry about that because this guy's going to be dead in one shot. So, let's just put him down. Put him in the ground! That's perfect. This guy, I can break all of his armor, or I could take some of his health. I think since I could do 6 damage, we might as well just do strength damage, because his strength also determines how much damage he's doing. So, let's just take off some of his hit points. I'm not even going to worry about the willpower. Oh man, I could drop him in one turn. Do I want to do that? I don't think I do. I think maybe I should whittle these guys down and then kill them when they're really low on health. That sounds like a better idea. So we're gonna whittle these guys down. I'm not gonna focus fire until I'm ready to put them in the ground. Now, how much extra willpower does this guy have? He has 6 of 4, so let's go ahead and move max. Ah, man, he broke 4 of his armor. Jesus H. Now see, that guy can break my armor. That's fine. Dude, Hakan is so fast now. Those boots are awesome. They were made for walking. Alright. Alright, he's gonna break armor. It's fine. This guy can... Let's go break his armor. Let's do bring the pain on this guy. Hell yes, 5 armor damage. Alright, now we need to... Now let's put this guy down. Because that other guy has taken a lot of hit point damage, so we're just gonna bury this guy too. Alright, so this guy's gonna get to go. I'm gonna put this guy in the ground. Wait, he already went. Let's kill this guy. Oh, I guess he gets to go twice. Alright, then we're gonna move here and bury this guy. That went swimmingly. Yeah. Kill a few more as they flee. So, there are 2. Bring it. Alright, who is up? Okay, he could come up here and break this guy's armor. Do we care about that? I think we might need to rally. Let's check and see what everybody else has. He has 5 of 5. He has 1 of 4. We're gonna rally Moger here. Give him 3 willpower. That sounds better. Ouch, he's going to hit him for 5. And I'm going to do that right back. I'm going to hit him for 5. I could hit him for 7. Let's do that. Now you have 3 strength. Ooh, shit, 8 damage? Wow! Holy hell. Oh man, wish my Warhawk could get up in there. Alright, he's gonna do... Yeah, that didn't work out too well for you, man. Alright, so I'm gonna move this guy here and break this guy's armor. Because he has an ass ton of armor. Oh my god. Hell yes, break 6 of his armor, I'll do it. Alright, who is next? Deflect. I'll take it. I guess this just guy's gonna hang in the back, because he can't get up there. It's fine. Having dudes in reserve is not bad. Oh my god, dude, he hits so hard like a truck! Alright, this is who? Eric. Pirate can do 4 damage to that guy. Let's do that, because he is hitting like a truck and it's not good. So we're going to do 6 damage to this guy. Nice dodge. Put him in the ground, Akon. Yeah. Moger can do 6 damage. Let's do it. Charm of the Wandering Mind. Nice. I like that. I like getting treasure. Renown. You know, I could probably, let's camp. I could probably leave my Warhawk out for now and get some other guys XP. But I also don't want to have these guys in the party because I hate looting so much. Alright, well anyways, let's see who needs promotions. Did anybody get a... Fossult got a promotion. Alright, let's see. What... He's a tank, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, he's a provoker. So let's put more armor on this guy. He can have 19 armor. That's pretty badass. Let's just go ahead and put 2 points into his armor, because I'll be able to max that out next level. Alright, that's good. We're done with that. Man. I'm fucking looting. Oh, I did get an item. What is that? Charm of the Wandering Mind. An engraving on this charm raises a fleeting thought may be more important than you think. Plus 20% dodge strength attacks. Every fifth attack is going to miss. I should put that on Gunulf, because his armor is shit. Or should I put it on one of the tanks? You know what? I should put it on the tank. I should put it on Fessolt, because he is a provoker. And I can taunt people and then they'll miss him. That sounds pretty good to me. Oh, he can't wear it yet. So until he can wear it, we're going to put it on Moger. And we might just leave it on Moger. Because Moger's also a badass. Alright. But I think I will move it to him at some point, because I could taunt, and then they'd be forced to attack him and miss. Which would be pretty awesome if that worked. regrets. Let's leave. Heading on. Deep inside the woods, you get the distinct sense that dredge have more or less surrounded you, and in great numbers. Their dark shapes create unsettling patterns as they slide between the trees in every direction. At least it's not as bad as it could have been if you hadn't taken out a good portion of them already, you think to yourself. You call Moger around. Any ideas, Moger? Yeah, pray to whatever god you like. There's more of them waiting on the other side of the woods than we've seen so far. We may be seriously outnumbered, especially if we wait. Irsa appears unexpectedly. What if, she says, patting her arrows knowingly, you could set part of the woods on fire to draw their attention while you escape or try to draw them into a trap. Was this your idea, you ask? She shrugs innocently. Let's draw them into a trap because I love to fight. You consider your options. Fight your way out as usual. Fight your way out as usual. Wait and see if they disperse, create a forest fire's distraction, draw them into the woods and set them on fire, lure them into the woods without the fire. I don't know if drawing them into the woods and setting the woods on fire is a good idea. Let's create a forest fire as a distraction. Is that a good idea? Man, I don't know. Yeah, fire. We don't like fire. We have 1,000 Varl. Yeah, right? Those guys are just bad. All their ideas, Luden, Irsa, that other guy, Bercy, they're just bad. All their ideas are bad. They're bad people. They do bad things. Let's not listen to a word they say. Let's lure them into the woods without the fire. No fire, you say, but an ambush is our best option. Irsa's eyes narrow, but she says nothing. Of course she says nothing, because she doesn't say anything. That's not a surprise. Her eyes narrow, but she says nothing. You could just put her eyes narrow. It's fine. Everybody knows she doesn't talk. Your shield bangers form a line and harass the dredge while archers pepper them with arrows. The frustrated dredge follow you back into the woods. Then things go wrong. You see Irsa flinging her fire arrows despite your orders. Of course! Of course. These guys need to die. I think I'm going to kill them. I don't care about this alliance between men and Varl. Obviously it never worked because all the Varl are dead in our current world. So, I'm going to kill Luden at some point, and I'm going to kill all these people because they're evil. Dead trees erupt, the flames burning quickly. I set no fire, you shout, but now both Dredge and Varl are panicking in the growing inferno. Luden rushes past in a state of terror. Fuck him. You break from the trees, hoping to regroup. Minus 20 Varl. Whatever, I don't care about minus 20 Varl. Where is Irsa? Oh, I can't wait. I'm punching him in the face. If I have this option, he's going down. Behind you are Varl following your lead, though not as many as you'd hoped. The dredge, distracted by the fire, have thankfully not yet noticed your escape. Isn't she with you? Oh, that's not him talking, Smoger. Isn't she with you? Did you make her do it? Where is she? I told her not to do it, Luden. Luden stares into the flames, face blank. He's trying hard not to show what this means to him. A miserable moment lingers. We got to get out of here, Khan. We bought minutes at the most. We don't know that she's gone anyway. Maybe she'll catch up to us, and then we can hang her or burn her at the stake. Moger gathers the others. Someone drags Luden along against his will, but you hear no outburst or insults. It's almost worse that way. Uja! What is up? Welcome to game with us. It's good to see you again. God, I can't wait to break Luden's scrawny little neck and hang his two accomplices. Although I know that's not what I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to get him there and the alliance of men and Vogar and everyone that's happily ever after. No, I don't think so. This guy lives in a brutal northern world. He's going to get hung or killed because I'm going to do it. I hate this guy so much. I don't even know if he's ever been hit in combat. I guess he has, but he needs to be punched in the face. Let's rest. I can't camp. Shit. My morale is only good. Probably because of the huge fire that bitch set. Oh, man. She's gonna get it. She's just gonna come back and we're just gonna let her back in the thing. Like, whatever. Oh, this doesn't look good. This is not good. You know it's a good story when you just, like, I just want to reach into the computer to strangle people. Like, at least I'm feeling something. I guess it's not hard to hate people, though. It's not hard to make you hate someone. Like, I don't want to even get to the story of Borderlands, so we're just gonna, drop that. Borderlands 2. What? Yeah. I mean, this game is... I like the characters in this game. I'm not saying that it's bad. I'm just saying it's easy to make a character hateable. Just having him do douchey shit all the time. But it's hard to make guys you think are awesome, but I think fucking Hugin and Mugen are fucking awesome as shit. What is this mess about? Looks like a full-scale battle happened, and recently. But only dredge bodies remain. Maybe we'll see something from the tower. Have Varl search the buildings and make sure there's no dredge waiting to spring on us. On it. And don't set up camp or make a fire. We'll take a look and then get out of here before anything else goes wrong. You mean more wrong.
You mean more wrong.
Alright, so I can check the tower or my heroes. I don't think I need to level. I think I've already done that, but let's check just in case. Oh, I can also switch my party. Man, I ought to take Luden just so I can get him knocked unconscious in every battle. I think that would be fun. I think that would be pretty fun. Let's take... I'm actually gonna switch out Bercy for... I'm gonna take the assholes and leave my rank 5 Warhawk here just because I could probably finish the fights without him, because Hakan is pretty badass and these guys need a level. And plus I could just charge Luden into every single fight and just have him get knocked unconscious. That would make me feel pretty good. Because fuck that guy. In fact, we'll put him second. Damn it. Turn order. Move him here. Put him second because I want to just charge him in the middle of the clusters of dudes and just have him get beat the fuck up. I like that. That's a good idea. Glad I thought of it. And he'll never level. He'll just stay at level 2 forever unless he gets lucky. Alright, let's check out. I guess the tower is it. Let's check it out. No, he's only level 1. That's awesome. Hopefully he stays there. Just gets knocked unconscious every fight. Or maybe I can have him kill steal people and level his way up to 5. What is that? Some people over there in this corner. I wonder if they're dead. Looks like some kind of spear maiden and an archer. They're the only two human corpses I see, if they're corpses. They may just be unconscious, but I guess we'll find out. Let's move Hakan forward some, because he's one of the fastest guys I have, so Alright, let's do this. Now, I am not about to charge into battle, so we're going to wait here for a couple turns. I would charge Luden in, but I actually want him to get some XP. But I will let him get beat up every single fight. We're going to rest. Oh, man, are there... Oh, God, these guys. Alright, well, I have to go up there now because... All of these guys are slingers, save for this guy here. Shit. Alright, well, that's good to know. So I have to get up in there. God, I hate slingers. Oh God, clear your hard drive and reinstall everything. Make sure to back up all your data before, well, I don't know even know if you could do that. I hope you have. Damn, I hope you have backups. Yeah, it doesn't sound like fun at all, dude. Alright, so let's see. What am I going to do? We're going to... We're going to move. Let's just get this guy chewed to ribbons. Let's just move him here. Alright, come on. God, it's going to take forever for these guys to get over here. Moger is trapped behind this rock. Or this hole. Ah, that's good. That's good. Glad you got that. Fuck a duck. What are we gonna do? I guess we're just gonna move tiny spaces. Alright, come on, bring it. Hit me. Move out of the way over here. I know it's gonna take too much willpower, but we gotta get up here. we're gonna just take this guy out. Bam. Alright. We've got Bercy. We'll just have Bercy walk alongside this guy. What are they doing? Are they... They're drawing me into the fight? Alright, so this guy needs to move out of the way so these... Both of these guys can go up here. They can't fit. There's three spaces. Shit. Like, Moger basically can't do anything. He is trapped back here. Like, even if he moves, he's stuck. Because there's only three spaces. Both these guys can't go this way. Alright, well, I'm just gonna have him stand next to this guy. Moger's gonna go this way. Not enough room for... to Varl. This guy is going to go forward because he's going to draw their attention and let little wimpy guy bring up the rear. Alright. We're just going to move our max movement towards the fight. And this guy can bring it on. Shit. Of course he can't do anything to this guy yet. So I'm gonna move him here. Tempest? Nope. End his turn. Alright, so I'm gonna do strength damage to this guy because I do not want him hurting me. So I have 14 and he has 4. What the fuck is that? Oh man. What a douche. What the fuck is that on the ground? God damn it. Shit. That didn't work. That sucks. And we can't go past those squares. Like, I'm sure we can. But what is gonna happen? Oh, hey, let's have him stand on it. Because fuck Luden. End his turn there. What is that? Is it a bomb? I don't know what it is. Man, are we gonna have Moger? I guess he could try to go around these guys, but too many bigs. What is going on here? Oh, I don't think so, dude. I don't think so. You're not summoning another guy. I don't know what those things are. Oh! It did blow up on him. You dumbass. Alright, so we're gonna go... We're gonna go as far up as possible because we need lots of room and we're gonna attack this guy. Can we kill him? I don't think we can. Yes, we can. Yay, let's put him down in the ground. No summoning for you. Alright, now they're in super mode. So they're gonna probably knock these two out before I get over there. Oh, that was so sweet to do to him. That was so awesome. You impale those guys and they run away and take a shit ton of damage. That is awesome. That is awesome. Good job, Luden. Get this guy here. No, do not end your turn. God damn it! God, the clicking on this game is fucking terrible sometimes. Take him out. Oh, yeah. Ha ha ha! Luden made it through a fight without dying. I can't believe it. He didn't get any renown, but whatever. Victory! Promotion! Watching on your phone. Damn, man. Damn. You lean on a crumpled wall. Who are these people over here? Watching endless waves of dredge marching below. Satisfied, Hakan? Moger asks. The vast number of dredge remind you of the great wars. I've seen enough, you reply. Let's get out of here. Moger stands over the bodies of the man and woman. Think the slag came up here for these two? Those two? asks Moger, waving his bloodied weapon in their direction. Any idea who they are? The man is dressed in light clothes, unfit for travel in the north. The woman wears an ornate but simple robe and shawl. No, but something's wrong about this, says Moger. He pauses, then puts his ear to the man's chest. This one's still alive, he says. The girl is not. The clang of metal reaches you from the courtyard below, muffled by the thick snow. You curse. Quick, back down. Bring the live one. You skip stairs as you descend, shouting orders to the varl below. Dredge line the battlefield. Weapons drawn. Alright. I got it. Charge. Time for a fight. Let's see. I'm gonna put Eirik on the field so they can just burn all their willpower. I'm gonna replace him with him. I like him for fighting those little weak, he's really good for fighting the, slinger guys, because he can hit them and they take 3 more damage. Let's see this battle. Alright, one shield guy, one two-handed weapon guy, and then some grunts. Let's move. Ready. Do I take people out at the very beginning? No. What? Wow. Legendary crafting items are no longer needed? What is the point? Why did they do that? I guess people were having a hard time farming them. Yeah. Wow. Alright, so let's see. So I have to ask myself, do I do strength damage to the big guy? Or do I completely take out one dude and possibly get myself knocked out? Well, that's a point. That's a fucking renown for me, so let's just do that. I don't give a shit. Let's move down in here. Take this guy out. One less guy to worry about. And he's gonna hit me for a whole 1 point of damage. Man, that does not look like looting. Man, I wish I could attack up to 2 squares away. I have a spear. Oh, we can! Man, armor damage or a point of strength damage? Let's do 3 points of armor damage. Good lord. He's gonna need some... Definitely need some, That was pretty good. I can't believe how well that worked out for me. Let's move here and break this dude's armor. With battering ram. Boom! Hell yes. He broke that dude's armor too. Ouch. That hurt a lot. Alright, so let's move Eirik up. And then let's rally Luden, because Luden's gonna need the willpower.
Thanks, I needed that.
Alright, he is getting his shit jacked. Let's do some damage before I'm taken out. Who to do damage to? This guy, he has 13 strength. Let's do 5 damage to him. Now he has 8 strength, which is better. Oh, sweet, and I did a point of damage to all these guys. That was perfect. Alright, so Luden. Let's move here and then impale this guy. Oh, I can't. Well, that sucks. Ooh, he could take a guy out. Spearmaster. He got a point of renown. I can't believe it. God. That guy jacked that dude. Alright, let's move this guy here. And take him out. Let's move over here and do some armor damage to this guy. Wow, Luden can take out another guy. I can't believe it. He promoted himself. I can't believe it. He can attack diagonal. It's pretty good. Spearmasters are pretty good. Luden sucks. Spearmaster's good. And he didn't die. Kill a few more. Let's do it. Alright, looks like there's 2 of them. That's terrible. I'm just gonna let them come to me. So we're gonna actually we'll take a step forward. We'll move my shield bangers up close. My whatever all these guys are called, they all have different names. Okay, Iric is at full health. Who needs C4, 2, 3? Let's see, what's he up? He has 3 of 4, 2 of 5, 4 of 4. 4 of 4, 4 of 5. I mean, I guess I could give some to Hakan, but Hakan's, I think, just gonna get knocked unconscious anyways. I mean, sure, let's rally Hakan. Alright, come on. Ah, look. That's hilarious. Here's Ubin back here carrying that dude. That's pretty cool. He's always there watching. Looks like I'm gonna get an archer that isn't a fucking nasty witch on Luden's side. I'm just gonna let these guys come to me, man. I'm not going up there. What are they doing? They're just wandering around. I will send Luden up there though. That would be hilarious. Yeah, bring it. Alright. Now the fun begins. These guys are going down. Come on. They get so many moves, man. Being the only 2 guys on the field. Come get some. Bring it. Thank you. come on, keep breaking your armor on me. Alright, we're gonna go and do 5 strength damage to this guy because we can. 6 damage, let's do it. Boom. Now he's a whopping 4 strength. Much better. And now we're gonna come up here and do 6 strength damage to this guy. Hell, we could do 8. Let's do it. Alright, this guy could take out either one of these dudes. Let's take out... who's next? It's gonna be... him, and then him, and then him. Let's take out this guy.
Promote!
Gonna need it, but whatever. Luden. Oh my god, Luden sick. Kill stealer. Dirty kill stealer. That was 2 fighter, minus 17 Varl. We won. Yeah. Right. What's going on? I had one eye on the fight. Next time I look down, dredge are swarming into the courtyard. Can't tell how many more are waiting out there. But it's a lot. If we're getting back across the bridge, it'll be a fight. Any options? Not really, unless you want to wade into that valley. We're going to have to leave the same way we came in. Khan, I think you should take a look at this. Nearby, the man had been bundled and laid near a short wall protected from the wind. I think this man is a mender. Oh, a healer? Finally, a healer! Jesus H. Christ, a healer! That raises more questions than it answers. What of it? The Spellweavers in Ridgehorn? Why? Maybe they knew something about what's happening. If he's going to tell us anything, we need to get out of here alive. But first we need rest, or let's go. But first we need rest. I need to level up. I agree. Let's decide how we're going to defend this dump in case they attack again.
Each day we wait here, the dredge are going to pile up. How many will there be tomorrow? Double? What about the next day?
Look, it's your call, Khan, but we can't cut and run on this one. There's one way out. If Varl fall, if anyone falls fighting here, they'll be left behind. Oh, shit. I'm not asking Luden what he wants to do. We wait for now. Let's make this place defensible. I'm not leaving anybody behind because I will lose all my dudes. We'll set up a watch, says Moger. Who knows what the dredge will do in the meantime. Might try to starve us out or wear us down. Might try to hide their numbers. What do you want to do? I'd rather focus on everybody getting rested and ready, and perhaps get ambushed. I don't care. Will do. When you're ready to leave, give the word. Until then, I'll see to it that everyone is in fighting condition before we make our escape. Alright, heroes. Let's promote people, if we can. Promote asshole. Alright, so what does he need? I might as well max out his strength because that seems to be one of his highest stats. Anybody else? Promote Gris. Alright, his stuff is maxed here. That's good. So let's do strong arm. Let's do more this and that. Provoker. Promote. Oh man. That's maxed. 19 armor. Alright, then we're gonna go here. Let's go back to Fassault. White Mugger. Let's remove that. Let's go to Fassault and add that. That way I can taunt people and make sure they attack me. And then he could just dodge. Plus he has 19 armor. What's that? What? Oh, cool. Alright, and then let's see what our morale is. If we need to rest, morale is great. Let's leave. I guess we don't need to rest after all, but I got to level up my fighters, which is a good thing. We're ready. What's our approach? Bait the dredge into attacking and wear them down. Break through the front lines and don't stop. Send the shieldbangers forward and fight defensively. Go all out, strike hard, drive them off, or send a diversion to draw their attention and escape. Let's do number one. Right, if we can get enough of them to split off, we can handle them a lot easier. Might be worth a try. We're doing it. You send Varl forward to harass the dredge. A couple come down to engage and are quickly felled, toppling over the cliff. No more take the bait. Instead, hurling exploding stones anywhere you're close enough. You have to change your tactics. Just gonna exploding stone us to death. We need to get out of here. Charge. Yeah, fuck that. I'm not gonna get pelted to death inside this damn keep. Let's go kill him. Alright, so we've got only one ranged guy. I'll send Luden after him. First things first, let's take this guy out. Yeah, Hakan gets a promotion. I think he's rank 5 now. Oh, holy shit. Luden can just take this guy out in one shot. That's what he gets for leveling up. I don't even think I need to move there. I can move right here. Damn, dude. Damn it. Why, Luden? Why you gotta be a badass in a fight? That sucks. I don't even need to impale him. I can just kill him. Straight out. Just dead. I can't believe it. Why does he have to suck so hard in story and be so good on the battlefield? Such a damn shame. Alright, I guess we're gonna try to engage this guy, but I don't know if he's gonna come fight me. We'll see. Where's he gonna go? He's not gonna fight me. But, let's see, he could do, holy shit, he has 6 health left. We're gonna get him out of the fucking fight. I don't want him to go down. I would rather him... I don't know if I'm gonna lose anybody, so... Of course he's gonna chase after him. Holy shit! Perfect! Perfect. I'm like, I don't want to lose him. Instantly kills him. Holy shit, he has 20 strength. Oh my god. I should not have killed that guy. I should have worn him down before I did that. Now he's on a fucking rampage. Alright, well, we're gonna do as much strength damage as we can to this guy immediately. Okay, if this thing would fucking work. Click here, click here, click here, click here. Bam! I cannot believe... I hope I don't lose him. I will absolutely restart my game in a heartbeat. Why does Impale only... he can attack from two squares away except Impale, which for some reason is only one. Yeah. I don't even think so, dude. You are not getting away with that. Not at all. Not even for a second. Please don't let me lose Iric. Archon, ready for a promotion. With the first wave of Dredge out of the picture, you stop and take stock of the battlefield. Your warriors are doing well, as you could hope. Fortunately, there were enough of them to pull it off. The Dredge are furious, but falling quickly. You think you could safely outdistance them at this point. You're almost free of the nightmare. What do you do? Leave no Dredge alive! Run from Dredge? Not after everything you've been through. You redouble your efforts. Every last one of them on the field are going to go down. Yeah! Leave no Dredge alive. He did me absolutely no good. Man, what to do? What to do? Maybe it was just bad timing. Shit. I ought to take Gunulf. Who to take? He doesn't need any more kills, though. But is Iric really going to get a kill? Man, that willpower regain, though, is awesome. Let's just keep him, and let's blow everybody's willpower, because he could give it back. No reason to save willpower. As long as I can keep Iric alive, that is. This is a weird setup. Okay, so we've got three slingers. So Luden needs to be up here. This looks good. I don't like these guys. But this looks good. We've got them pinchered in. Let's do this. So, now, I can take this guy out. Man, I don't know what to do. I don't like leaving two guys on the field. And he doesn't need any more kills. Shit, what to do? What is the best thing to do here? Do I take two guys? Do I take one of them out? I think I should. I think that's just smart. I'm gonna do it because I do not want this guy running around the field. I just don't. So, we're gonna do it. I'm just gonna have to deal with these guys running around like jackasses. I'm just gonna move guys or max towards the enemies. God. Use all my willpower moving. While they whittle me away. Still rally. Does anybody need willpower at this point? 5 of 4, 4 of 4, 7 of 5, 7 of 5, and 5 of 4, so no. End his turn. I guess this is just the way it falls. I can't just... I'm not going to just let these guys pick me off while I try to get kills for everybody else. I'm just going to let the fight go out. How did he live through that? Motherfucker. Alright, we're going to go up here and we're going to impale this guy because I don't even need to impale him anymore. Jesus Christ. Oh my god, he got another promotion. That's good, whatever. Whatever. Hey, that worked out. He didn't kill him, I thought he was going to. And now, Mogre can. That works out perfectly. Works out perfectly. I couldn't have hoped it. Because I was like, well, I guess I'm just going to have Hakan kill him, even though he doesn't need the renown anymore, but didn't work out like that, so it's all good. I can't do anything. Okay, so we're moving on. We got out of there alive. Here we go. To Grafheim. Schlid. We're almost there. We're almost to Grafheim. I made it almost without killing Luden yet. Are we going to starve to death? That was a long way to travel. Uben. Hakan, join me a moment. There's something I thought you'd want to see. It's a welcoming party from Grafheim. Bearing mead? That's about the only thing I want to see. No such luck. The mender from Ridgehorn woke up. He says his name is Eivind. Sounds like a mender name. How is he? Not well. Where are we? Oh, it's not a bow. It's a staff. Eivind. Not well. Where are we? A day or two from Grafheim. We found you at the Tower of Ridgehorn. What were you doing there? Grafheim. No. No, no. That's the wrong way. Juno. Where is she? Where is the woman who is with me? She didn't make it, my friend. We only brought the living with us. No, we have to go back. I don't think so. We barely made it out 2 weeks ago. Do you know why the dredge were crawling all over Ridgehorn? Dredge, we have to go back! It's a damn graveyard, boy. I'm sorry, Eivind. The girl was dead when we got there. What we have to do is tell Jorundur what's happening and prepare for a bloody war. So if you... She is dead. I couldn't save her. I couldn't save her. Avon suddenly looks spent. He slips to the ground, and you motion for some Varl to help him onto the cart. Not what I had hoped to hear. Not sure what I was hoping. Come on, Ubin. Sooner we get to Grafheim, the better.